I know there's a door right in front of us, so... Oh, fuck, what is that? What is that? What is that? That's some kind of, like, cockroach monster. Never seen that before. Hey everyone, my name is Mike and welcome back to Resident Evil HD Remaster. Alright, so we've been inside this lab once before. We've figured out a few little clues here and there with a few passcodes for a computer. We just came back to the chest to get the MO discs. We had one already and we picked one up in the labs itself. So we're making our way back now to the computer where we can put these discs in the hard drive, the disc drive, excuse me. So, we're gonna quickly, I think we may have downed a few zombies and possibly they could be coming back if we stand over them. So we've got to be a little bit careful where we go. So the plan here is to actually unlock some doors because there is a few that are electronically locked. So let's go down these stairs, through these doors. Just before we carry on, I should really equip the Magnum, because I had Barry's Magnum on me and I switched it out for this one because I don't think Barry's Magnum uses the ammo that we find. So let's go through these doors. I think this is one of the doors where the clues were for the password. So, and I also figured out the there's x-rays on the wall in this room and there's a note on the side of the wall saying the initials of each one needs to be in alphabetical order, and if you put it put the switch on, we can see again that parts of each x-ray, an organ is highlighted and the first letter from each organ is what we need. So just come out with this, we've got, I think with this one it's the esophagus, so, and then that's not the first one. So these were already put in alphabetical order, and what we've got is the colon, which is C. So we got the first letter from that one. Then we got esophagus, which is it E? I think esophagus is spelled with an E. If we are not sure, we can come over here. Yeah, you can see it's E at the top there, top right, esophagus. So we got CE, the first letter of each one. That's the liver. So CEL, and the lungs. So cell, that should be. Just because my biology is not 100%, I just want to make sure that is the liver. Yeah, it is. So the password for the computer, I'm thinking, is cell, because that's what each letter spells out, you know? And also, we got the username from here, which was John Ada on the computer in the other room. So we're going to use John Ada as the username and cell as the password to unlock, I think it's B2, the doors on B2. Now, we can make our way to where the computer was. I think it may have been in here. We have got something moving in here. I think we killed a zombie in here at one point. I'm not sure if we took his head off or not. Okay, there's nothing around, so we must have killed him. Okay, this is the room with the disk drive, not the actual computer. So a security system passcode transmission device. If you had an MO disk, you could transmit the passcode to the system. So, we're going to use the first one that we've got. Okay, so each disk is going to unlock a door. So, that, it doesn't matter, like, they're all the same, really. They all unlock a different part of the door. Okay, so this is the light that switched on. So, if we come over here now. Levers are releasing the door locks. It looks usable, pull it. Okay, so we're gonna pull the middle one. It doesn't, I think we obviously do need to pull all three of them to unlock the doors. Okay, so this disc is not working here, so we'll have to move on. We have got one thing we can try, and that is going to that other room where the computer is and logging in with the password being cell, C-E-L-L. Which is through the corridor, and I think it's on the other end of the corridor. Now there could be some zombies in front of us here. We have got one there in front of us, I think. That's obviously dead. It may come back as a super zombie. They're called Crimson Heads. I call them super zombies just because, you know, that's what it makes me think of. Try and get round this one without killing it. There we go. So because that other... Hang on, there's a door here. Have we checked this one? It looks like it's probably going to be locked. Yeah. So all these doors are unlocked by electronic unlocking. So this is the only other door that we've got that works, I think, in the labs. And this should be where the computer is. So if we come over here into this corner, I need to log in again. I think, yeah, the login was John, and the password was Ada. What type of keyboard is this where the letters are in alphabetical order? Crazy shit. I think it was, which one was it that we couldn't unlock? I think it was 2F possibly. Yeah, so let's try cell as the password. Hey, normally when that happens, okay, permission granted, awesome. So B2F, that is upstairs now. So we should be all done. In there. Okay, so there's only really one way we can go now, which is the new door that we just unlocked. We should be up the stairs as we go around this corridors. Try and get past this guy. Nice and easy. Okay, so go through this gate at the end of the corridor, up the stairs. And then as we get to the top of the stairs, go down the corridor. Should be a door we can go through. I just hope that these zombies don't get back up. This is the door we just unlocked. Now, what have we got in here? We've got a healing spray on the desk. Let's have a little search around, see what we've got. We've got a projector here. Okay, so we have a... the film has been set into place. View it. Umbrella. Bio-organic weapon official report. Cerberus. This is the... Also, they have tested on the dogs. It's not like the dogs got infected by accident. That was meant to happen. The sharks. Neptune. Hunter. Which were the swamp monsters. Tyrant. We haven't come across a tyrant just yet. Bioorganic weapons research group. Development staff. These are the bastards that have had everyone being killed. There's a serial number there. Alright, I think... We have this slide filter as well. We're going to use this. So this may be something different. An official report. It looks like it might be the same thing, actually. Although it's a slightly different colour, which is strange. Okay, so those numbers at the end, actually. They were different. We get to the last slide. 8462. That was different. So maybe, I think we put a filter in front of it, I think that we just put in from our inventory. So it highlights the numbers, 8462, so we'll need to remember them. I'm bound to forget it, to be honest. So it looks like we've got some shotgun ammo over here. We can always do with more shotgun ammo. Let's pick up the healing spray as well, you know, why not? Because we have got quite a few free slots available. And there's a door. Let's quickly check the map. Right, there are still some things we can pick up in this room. I think there's a door over here. Is this a door? It's not a door. Is that a window? I can't even tell. The camera angles are having given me a bit of trouble and find... Okay, here we go. A passcode entry terminal. Use it, yes. Okay, 8462. Did that work? Yes, it did. Okay, so that was a door. It was just a secret door. There's also something over here. Okay, we got the last MO disc. Well, not the last one, actually. I think there was 4 required. And we already put one in, so we have 3 now. What do we have here? The laboratory key. Where was the door that might work on? I can't remember. Some sort of image editing equipment. It looks like you can use it to view Kenneth's film. View the film. Oh, we got this film ages ago. Kenneth was the first dead body that we found in the mansion. And when we picked it up, it said, I wonder what's on it. I kind of predicted that it would be him getting his face eaten off. And I wasn't wrong, I guess. So that's just kind of like a little like Easter egg type thing, if you like. It's not exactly anything we need to look at. So we went in there for that laboratory key. So we have got a new key. We've also got a new MO disc. Now, I can't remember if we needed 3 MO discs or 4. Either way, we'll need to go back to that room and put the disc in. I'm guessing that you need to put the discs in a specific order to make them work. Let me just quickly check what's behind us. Right, the only way to go now is downstairs. Although there is something we haven't picked up in here. Okay, so security protocols. Heliport for executive use only. This restriction does not apply in the event of an emergency. Okay, so there's a few escape routes here, it looks like. Security protocols. A passage to heliport. Entry is prohibited unless accompanied by a consultant, researcher, or the chief of security. Unauthorized persons entering the heliport will be shot on sight. Okay, elevator. The elevator stops during emergencies. So it looks like our escape is going to be through a helicopter to get out of this whole shit chaos place. Okay, so visual data room for use by this special research division only. All other access to the visual data room must be cleared with Keith Irving, who's a room manager. Okay, so we could probably do with reading all that to kind of have an idea of where to go when shit hits the fan, but I think we'll probably figure it out as we go. It'll be the room that's last unlocked, I think. That will be the escape room. Okay, so let's go back downstairs. We've got a new MO disc to try out, and we've also got this new key that will unlock a new door. Not too sure which door it's going to be. I know there are 2 doors that we haven't been through. Whoa, fuck! Yes, we killed him in one shot. That's really nice. So that guy that was in the corridor, he's eventually come back. Now that we've only got 1 zombie in all this corridor section, it should be pretty easy to avoid him. You know, we don't need to worry about taking him out. So we use the laboratory key. Now, it didn't discard it, so it must be able to use it here as well. Let me just try that. Okay, so we've unlocked 2 doors now. We'll discard the key. Let's just try this one out first. Alright, so this is like a proper laboratory now. It's rusted shut. Which way can we go? So there's a door directly in front of us. Look at the door to the left of Jill's position there was locked. So we'll try this one first. Hopefully we'll find another disc. That'd be pretty cool. Okay, there's a security box in here. Security box? What am I talking about? It's a item box. Some shells on the ground, shotgun stuff, all that nice stuff, and a typewriter. Alright guys, I've just saved right there. Picked up all the items in the room. We're left now with the 2 compact discs, healing kit, and a revolver with the ammo. So let's leave this way. Let's carry on searching down the corridor. So what we're looking for really is another disc and it to go along with the other 2 that we've still got in our inventory. And that should be all the discs that we need. So this door is unlocked. Okay, so there's some weird noises happening in here. Just gotta be careful of what's ahead. I know there's a door right in front of us, so... Oh, fuck, what is that? What is that? What is that? That's some kind of, like, cockroach monster. Never seen that before. This revolver is pretty badass, though, you know? 1 shot right there, and we've still got loads of ammo. There was one in front of us there, because Jill auto-aimed towards it. And I think we may have killed it, judging by the sound it made when we shot it. Yeah, we did kill it. Okay, so this Magnum is this wrecking face. We've got something over here. Warning, fuel may explode if shaken or jarred. We had that before with something else. A refueling device for the power room. Okay. It's not working right now because there's no fuel. There's an empty capsule. Will you take the fuel supply capsule? Yes. Just quickly check the map. Right, it's flashing green now. We don't need to go down that way. I think there's a monster down there. But there's a door this way, so we're going to go this way. Looks like there might be infinite spawns there with those guys. They keep jumping in through like cracks in the walls. Right, so we got to be quick getting around here. Let's just check this far end first. There's a monster behind us. Whoa, hasn't he got a head? He's got no head, and he still hit me. He hit me at the swing when he had no head. A security system passcode transmission device. Okay, so it seems that we need to use a different MO disc on different consoles. Looks like each console you can only be used once. So that's it. Yeah, there is only three. So we've got the last disc that we need to get. And just need to find the last console. How much did he hit me for? I'm fine still, that's good. So maybe there we go. I was going to say, there's going to be something to pick up in here. And I think it's just this battery pack. So we'll pick that up. Maybe a monster in front of us. Yep. Oh my god, this is amazing, this weapon. I'm in love with this weapon. Although it's like Resident Evil, and it's known for having like awkward aiming, it's actually not that bad, because there is a slight, small amount of like auto-aim in it. She just turns to where they are when if you're not aiming at them. Now it looks like if you look at the map, you can see it loops around and it goes into the circle. I think there's going to be like a console there for the discs. So I'm going to make a quick run around. There's going to be a zombie monster somewhere. There we go. What have we got here? What is this? There's no power to the main elevator. Okay, so it looks like start it up. The system won't initialize. It appears to need some kind of fuel to get started. Okay, so we've got the fuel supply capsule. Obviously, if we use it now, it's not going to work because it's empty. So we need to go back now and fill it up. So let's make a move. Hopefully, we can run around the far side of this place and not get attacked by this guy. There's one here! There's one there! What's this? The lab self-destruct mechanism. It's huge. Okay, go, go, go. Just get out of here. We don't want to waste too many bullets there because it does seem to look like they do respawn over and over again when you kill them. So let's make a run for it. We need to fall back. I know there was a place where it said warning about handling a fuel very delicately. So we're going to head back there, I think, and try and fill up the fuel capsule in there. Oh, let's go away, please. Which way are we going? Let's quickly check. Okay, there's the door next to us there. Hopefully they reset every time you enter the room, so we can just run in before they jump down. You know, it'd be pretty easy to get past them then. So the door on the far end, it seems to be locked. Let's just check it out, because we haven't actually looked at it. Yeah, it's an elevator. There must be a need to fill the power up for it. We might need to reload as well. So there's also this door that we haven't actually been in. So we'll try this out. There's still some noises being made in here. It's only a small room, this one, like a storeroom. Maybe we can find something useful. What am I doing? We can push this. Just before we do push it, I want to quickly have a look around, see what we've got. We haven't got anything really, so we'll have to push this. Looks like we've got some ammo on the shelf. Some shotgun ammo. Anything else to be found in here? Yes, there is. Can we push any more shelves? Maybe we can jump on this. Here we go. Can we climb in the vent? Would we want to? Okay, it looks like we're going through the vent. Now, where are we in here? Okay, we're in the locked... Oh, God. Shit. Get away. I can't see you properly, bitch. I think we shot it. Pretty sure we shot it. There might be two, though. That camera angle is awful, isn't it? Okay, so he's dying. What do we have in here? God. Okay, so this is the door that was rusted shut. I think there's another air vent we can go through. On the other side. I'm trying to see if there's anything we can find in this room. Okay, it's actually flashing green now, so it is not. I don't really know why we came in here then. Maybe we have to go through here to get to the next room. Try and get past this guy. There he is. Okay, there's quite a few vents here. Let's go through this one. I don't actually know where we're going to be ending up. I don't know where we are. What do we have over here? Looks like we got a battery pack. Is this another computer? Yes, 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 yes. It's the last one we need. So we're going to put the ammo disc in there. While we've got these creatures bouncing around. So that's all three of them now unlocked. So we're opening up quite a lot of the lab here. We got opening up with keys, passcodes. Making some good progress out here. Okay, there's a guy in my face. we're all done now in there. So we have to leave now. Oh god, I thought he was going to get me. I think we're best going to leave in just by going out, you know, through all these vents. Just rush across now. Rush across. There's another vent there. I want to see what this one is. You can't actually go through that. Never mind. I think that's where the monsters jump in through. So let's jump down. Alright guys, it seems like it's a pretty safe little room here. So we're going to end it here, guys. And we'll carry on by checking out what those unlocked doors. I'm going to pause it quickly because it sounds like something's coming towards us. Yeah, we'll check out what's behind that door with the three locks on it. And a few other things as well. So thanks for watching, guys. And see you guys next time. Bye.